Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is notes payable. As you can see, I'm going to show you an extract which is taken from the notes payable on the real estate. Let's read something. The company had loans secured by real estate, and the majority of which are construction loans, which consist of the following. Then there's the detail given over here, that the couple of notes that have been noted down here, and the total notes payable on real estate is 256,158 and 149,704. So this is just an extract to show you, but we need to learn what exactly is the notes payable. So in simple term, notes payable is basically nothing but a promissory note. What is it? It is a promissory note, and this promissory notes is basically offered by the lender to the borrower of the company. Lender to the borrower, or for an arrangement between these two. So under this agreement, the borrower is basically, you know, bound to pay a certain amount to the lender within a stipulated time frame, along with the interest. So the interest rate is fixed by looking at two factors. The first factor, the lender looks at the time period. The lender looks at the time period for which the amount has been loaned. And the second and the most important thing, the lender looks at the best customers and then sees what's the prime rate. And the prime rate is the interest rate that the commercial banks charges their best customers. So depending on these two factors, the interest rate for such payables with a specific customer is decided. So now, before we go into the detail about how notes payable in the balance sheet is treated, let's first talk about the difference between the notes payable and the accounts payable. Let's understand the difference between both of them. Now, the difference between notes payable and the accounts payable. See, in usual terms, both notes payable and accounts payable, they serve one single purpose. That they know the one purpose that it forces the customer to pay off the loaned amount. But the notes payable and the accounts payable are not that similar. They have many differences. The major ones are something like this. The promissory note, that's the first thing that we'll discuss. See, the major difference between the accounts payable and the notes payable is that it's a matter of the promissory note. Now, notes payable is a promissory note which is received by the borrower. It is received by the borrower and from the lender. But in the case of the accounts payable, there is, you can say, okay, let me just bifurcate over here between the two, the difference between the accounts payable and the notes payable. We just write over here. So in case of the accounts payable, what's the case? There is no promissory note involved, and there is a promissory note that has been involved. Second, the interest rates. In the case of the accounts payable, the customer basically it does not need to pay any interest. But in the case of the notes payable, the customer needs to pay interest, and it is decided by the lender. The third important is the penalty. Now, in case of the notes payable, if the customer delays the payment, the interest will increase. Interest can increase. But in the case of the what we call as accounts payable, a penalty amount is added to the loan amount if the customer delays the payment. Fourth, the extension. Now, notes payable is an extension of the accounts payable. It is an extension of the accounts payable. When a customer isn't able to pay the required amount within the time frame, the customer needs to sign a note, and this note is issued by the lenders to the borrower to increase the time period, and as a result, the customer needs to pay the loaned amount plus the interest. Okay, both the things. Now, this means that when a customer is unable to pay the amount due to in time, her liability or transfers from the accounts payable to notes payable. So these are some of the most important differences between the accounts payable and the notes payable, which one needs to know before getting into the nitty-gritty of the same. Now, there are a thing called short-term notes payable. Now, what exactly this is? See, firstly, you need to understand that the company puts notes payable as a short-term liability, right? So when the duration of that particular note payable is due within a year, the short-term notes payable example of CBRE, you know, which had a closely of current portion of notes, it was standing 133.94 million in 2005. So it is like, you know, immediately payable. But there are a thing called long term notes payable. If the notes payable is due after 12 months or more, then this is considered as the long term liability. Now, let's understand the journal entry part of this. See, it is very important to understand the journal entry for the notes payable. Doing so will enable an individual to comprehend the nitty-gritty of the notes payable. Let's get started now. Please note that, you know, the entry is being recorded in the journal entry of the payee, meaning that who is entering the notes on the balance sheet, meaning the customer here. The first entry is going to be cash account that will be debited, which is 1000. To the notes payable, that will be 1000. So here we have passed the entry in the books of accounts because it indicates the customer has borrowed the money in lieu of the notes payable. And we have debited cash is because it's an asset. And when we receive the cash, the asset gets increased. When an asset gets increased, we debit the account. And at the same time, we credited because it is a liability as the liability gets increased, right? And when the liability gets increased, we credit the account. So this is how the journal entries form. Now the next entry would be an entry for the interest expense. Now from the customer's point of view, the interest payment is an expense, but the customer is yet to pay the interest. So here's the journal entry we'll pass in the books of accounts of the customer, which is the interest expense account that will be debited, let's say 150, to interest payable, that will be 50, and will, because the amount will go out somewhere close to 100, let's say, so to cash. In this journal entry, we have debited the interest expense. Interest expense is the expense when the expense increases, and we debit the account. At the same time, we have credited the interest payable. Why? Because interest expense has not yet been paid fully off in full. So that's why we are treating it as a liability. And when the liability increases, we credit the account. And here the company has paid off the part of the interest. And that's why we have credited the cash account, because when the assets decreases, we credit the account. Then there would be a journal entry when the amount would be paid off in full in the interest payable. So in this case, we'll pass the journal entry something like this. The notes payable account will be debited to the interest that is payable. That's going to be the entry 1050. This won't be credited. This will be debited. That will be 50 to cash account, which will be credited. That will be 1050. So what we need to note here, that the above journal entry here will be passed only at the time of paying off the entire amount. And here we'll debit it because there'll be no liability anymore, right? The notes payable, there'll be no liability anymore once the full amount is being paid off. We'll also debit the interest payable because that portion of the interest was due, but not now. And we are creating the cash account because the cash as an asset is going out from the company. Since the cash is an asset, when it decreases, we'll debit the account.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.